Hey fellow photographer, how's it going? In this little video, I would like to show you my way to avoid the file backup and distribution headaches that I have right after a photo shoot. Now, what I'm using is a little tiny application named Sugarsync, and it directly backs up my photos via an internet connection to an online storage. And I think that it's really worth it because computer scientists say that nothing exists digitally unless it exists in two separate physical locations. And these locations are not your CF card and your mobile hard drive, which end up in the same photo bag, and the photo bag might get stolen the next day when you arrive at the airport and do the check-in and it's gone. No, it should be really in physically separate locations, and this is what this little application just does. It's very flexible, and it's rock solid. It just runs as a background task. It shuffles data whenever there's an internet connection, and it does it really fast. And it never complains if the connection is gone or anything. It just works beautifully. It supports my workflow really good because it's very flexible. In theory, this application not only backs it up to to an online server, it syncs whatever folders I want to have synced from my laptop, let's say, to other computers, and vice versa. Now, whatever I tell SugarSync to sync, it will sync. And that's beautiful. It does so with computers, with iPad or iPhone or BlackBerry, whatever. It really doesn't matter. And I use it, manage my sync folders to sync it mainly from my laptop, and I sync them to my workstation. And let's say I finish the photo shoot in China, then I tell SugarSync to sync this folder, and it will upload it directly to the online storage. So the files end up in the USA in SugarSync's online storage, and at the same time it syncs it to my workstation at home in Germany. So when I come back from the trip, my files are already on the workstation, and all the time they are safe because they're really in different locations. It's really beautiful. It's really good. It does even more. I also use it to share files, to share photo files mainly. And let me come up with the file manager. Let's say I had the photo shoot and I reworked the files and I made a zip file. It's 1.5 gigabyte. And I want to share it with my client or with the model or whoever. Then I just pull it into my public share folder on my hard drive. It's done. I mean, or it's not really done, I have to go here and say, give me a public link. And it copies a link into my clipboard, and this is the link I mail to my client. I can have the link even if it's not uploaded yet. SugarSync directly gets me the link, and it will upload the file in the background. And all I have to do is move it into another folder of my hard drive. I don't have any stress with uploading or anything. It just happens in the background, and that is so smooth and beautiful. But you can even take it a level further, and I did so because I have a business plan of SugarSync, which allows me to bring in team members. It gives them specific rights to folders and sync folders with them. Why not? And one team member that I have is Renzi, and Renzi needs access to a folder called 07 All Photos Full Resolutions, which I share with him. And there he is. That's Renzi. And whenever I change something in the folder, I add a file or rework a file or whatever, it's changed on Renzi's hard drive as well, and vice versa. It's a cool way to work with each other without caring about sending files back and forth. It's just done. Same with another colleague, with Gina. I've got heavy file transfer with Gina, so I share a folder with her, and she puts in files that I should receive into a subfolder named To Michael, and I put into another subfolder files that she should receive, and we don't have to care about uploading. We just do it on our hard drives, and it's done. It's really cool. I think it supports pretty much every workflow, and I think you should try it out because it's really convenient. If you go via my affiliate link below, then you will end up on a page where you can get a 30-day trial, 30-day free trial. And I would suggest you do that and try it out first if it suits your workflow. I think it does. And if you find it useful and if you find this video useful, then I would really like it if you go via my affiliate link, because if you later decide to sign up or to buy anything from them, then I might get paid a little commission, and that would be wonderful. But anyway, in any case, I suggest try it out. I hope you found it useful. I hope to see you in the next video, and until then, good light.